Yes, I have a lot of funny stories. I had to figure out which one, but this one is funny and painful.
Okay.
But I'll tell you. So, all
right, cool.
All right, so this was back in 2019.
Okay.
No, 2018. I'll take that back. Okay. So I meet this chick randomly. She had slid into my DMs, and so she was kind of like really persistent. She was just like, yeah, I want that. I want you. So I was just like, all right, whatever. So I ended up seeing her at a show.
Okay.
So cool. So, you know what I'm saying? I meet her at the show for the first time, and we like, you know, we caught the vibe. I'm like, look, I'm trying to take it down. You with it?
Right.
She was like, yeah, I'm with it.
So did I said, just like that?
Just like that. That didn't have time. I'm trying to take it down. You with it?
You already on Wild and
Out. I'm thinking I'm a nigga. I had lost a little bit of weight. I talk to women differently. I've lost some weight.
Oh,
I lost 200 pounds. Like, you with it or not?
You fucking or nah? Let me know.
You see the goddamn tattoo?
You know what it is.
Hey, why don't you give me your number before I don't want her no more?
Exactly.
So she's like, yeah, I'm with it. So we was out in the East. And so I'm like, I live in the Valley. You trying to drive out there? She was like, I'm with it.
Right.
So she comes out, we smashed. Now, mind you, should I have worn a condom? I should have.
You should have.
But for whatever reason, I was just like, nah. Like, you know what I'm saying? Just, I had one of those moments, I wanted to feel it. So, you know what I'm saying? We had sex, whatever. It was cool. So then I'm thinking, it is what it is. Mind you, I'm on my Playboy shit, so I ain't really hearing about talking to her no more. 3 months later, she hits me up. She's like, hey, sir, I'm late. I'm like, okay, where are you going? Like, you know what I'm saying? What does that mean? She was like, nigga, I was like, well, you should speed up. You should plan your time accordingly.
Either I'm not sure why you're calling me
exactly.
on here. Like, I can't help you. Because
literally, I only hit one time.
Right.
So I'm just like, okay. And she was like, yeah, I'm pregnant with your child. I'm like, okay, you're pregnant. And so I say, okay. I said, listen, I've had situations like this happen before. Listen, I'm really sensitive because I really want more kids. I really do. I said, listen, I know that, you know, I don't know you from nothing. We don't have no relationship. If there is a possibility this kid is not mine, if you've been with anybody else, please just tell me now.
Right.
She was like, no, you're the only person I've been with in the past year. This your baby. So I'm like, okay. So the time starts going by. So I'm like, you know, and as time's going by, I'm like, well, okay. You like, it starts to grow on you. You know
right,
what I'm saying?
Right,
my father.
Right.
So I'm just like, you know, she's an attractive young lady. I'm like, and then we find out she's having a girl. So I'm like, I'm getting excited.
Right.
I'm like, but I can't tell the world.
Right.
Because I told her at the top, I said, look, when you have this baby, we're going to test it. Like,
right.
You know what I'm saying? She's like, oh, no. She was like,
right.
I wouldn't respect you as a man if you didn't test
right,
it.
Right.
I'm like, cool. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So then time starts going on, and I'm starting to get more and more tests. But I can't say nothing publicly
because
I don't, you know what I'm saying? I don't know. But so then I named the baby. I'm at the baby shower. Like, I'm giving
money.
What's the
name of the baby?
Huh?
What was the name of the baby?
Jada.
Okay.
Yeah, so I'm doing the whole shit. I'm like, this is going to happen. It's okay, cool. Like, oh, then I'm, you know what I'm saying? I'm having sex with her because I'm just like, I don't want you having sex with somebody else. You know what I mean? If my baby's in there, of course I'll do it. So long story
short.
With
no condoms.
No condoms. Well, like, cool. We know how to do this clearly.
Right? Exactly.
Cool. All the time goes on. So by the time this shit happens, I'm like, okay, this is cool. So at the time, I was doing a podcast with Kev on Stage, Righteous and Ratchet. So I go to him and I'm like, bruh, I got to be able to announce to the world that I have a kid.
Right.
I know this kid is mine. Let's just do a DNA test.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I'll get the answers on the episode. He was like, all right. He was like, well, do you want to just find out first and then we can go and do it? I said, nah, man, I know it's my baby, man.
Right.
I want honest reactions. He's like, all right, cool. Nigga. So, okay. So that was okay. So mind you, I go through the whole thing. The baby's born. I look at the baby. Hold the baby. Look at the baby. Oh, baby, beautiful. Oh,
damn, this is
the baby. Oh. That was the most difficult thing to do was to administer the DNA test because the baby is
gorgeous.
A minute old.
Oh,
gorgeous
man.
Baby. Yeah. And I'm like, oh, yeah. Baby. Oh. Say hi for daddy. Oh. Wiping the cheek.
Oh,
shit.
So
fast forward. It's a DNA test. So I'm just ready to announce to the world. I already have a YouTube page set up
for
no boy and his baby.
Oh, wow.
The whole shit.
Wow.
Nigga, Kev reads the response. Nigga, you are not the father. I'm like, man.
You should have known when the baby wasn't fat.
The messed up part was, that ain't even the fucked up part. The messed up part is, I did what any logical nigga would do. I sent her a text like with the results. I sent a screenshot of the results. And then I sent this emoji.
Right. Any logical nigga would do that.
Exactly. Nigga, she hits me back like, my bad. I'm like, then
my
I talked to her.
Bad.
Then I talked to her. I'm like, so what's up, this baby? She was just like, I definitely know whose it is now. I'm like,
wow.
Then she hit me up later, like, yo, can we go to lunch and talk about this? Bitch, I don't want to talk about chicken fingers. I don't want to talk about.
So did you have to, like, you pay for diapers?
Man, I was so ready to be a father. Just, like, it wasn't that, you know, typically when people, like, doing the DNA test, they don't want to be the father.
Right.
I absolutely wanted to be the father. The baby wasn't mine. And then I looked stupid on my podcast. Like, I felt so stupid. Like, wait, what?
Did what? Cam say? What
that nigga was just like, no, you're not the father. I'm like, nigga, read it again. Absolutely the father. I didn't name this baby. Fuck you, nigga. Absolutely my child.
It's absolutely
baby was
my
not
child.
Mine. And then just her just response was just like,
I know who it is now.
I was just like, bruh. So, yes, that's... Amongst all of the stories in my life, that's one of the craziest.
That's funny as hell.
I also bought a car that didn't go in reverse knowingly.
Oh, come on. Tell that story. We so, give two. We got time for a second.
Really
one.
Quickly. So I all went right. to a place called Repos R Us. And I don't know why I would go to buy a car called Repos R Us. And they sold me a car, but I only had $500 for the down payment.
Right.
So the nigga was like, yo, the car don't go in reverse. I was just like, he was like, but don't worry. Just get it. We'll get it. We'll fix it after you buy it. So I was in church at the moment, and so I like rationalized it in my mind, like, God don't want me going backwards in life no more. He only wants me to go forward. I rationalized it.
Real quick, why is it that all church niggas do shit like that?
Yo,
why does every it's like anything that happened in life, y'all
it,
be like, God wanted me to
God.
It must be.
And I was just like, you know, and I wanted a truck. I was like, God don't want me going backwards in life no more. So I drove around with a car. He was just like, you gotta have it for like 2 weeks and then we'll fix it. So for 2 weeks I was driving the car and I just couldn't go in reverse. You get real creative. You can only park in spots where you can go, you know, straight, whatever. Long story short, I ended up falling behind on my payments the second month, and then they came and repossessed the car that I got that didn't even have...
That went reverse.
Yes. They fixed it, and then it was able to go forward, but then they came and repossessed my shit. I'm like, nigga, I bought it with reverse. I could have just gave me some good grace.
Right.
They took it the next month.
Your
so.
Problem was you bought a car that was from a place called Repos R Us.
Exactly.
So you know the car
I said,
was
I
didn't
know that they
up.
Wasn't playing. Wait. But I thought that they couldn't jump the gate to get in my apartment. So I was like, they can't jump a gate to get in. Them niggas jumped the shit out.
I missed a whole bunch. So did they take back a car that couldn't go backwards?
Yes. No, they ended up fixing
that's
it.
Funny. That's
but they
funny.
So once they fixed it and then they took it and they sold it to another nigga and then he got to be
that is- He reaped all the benefits. He reaped all the benefits.
All the
exactly.
benefits.
I know it is hot as
hell in here. I know he
I'm
said
trying
it.
To play the role.
Yeah, but it's all good. But you the great thing is it won't show up on camera that we're sweating. But yo, this was fucking fun as shit.
My life is crazy and it doesn't make any sense.